at all the parameters and arranged marriage, but really, it's finally your luck. You nowadays hearing so many companies which were really the blue bloods, and still things have come out which are least expected.
It's a thing which you feel you can grow with the company, you can contribute to the company, and which means that you need to study back, go back and see what are the industry trends, what are the sector trends.
We are not going to be offered Tata boards, GE boards when we start off, right? And then if you're only going to be, you know, looking at, you know, and all boards may not have Deepak Parekh and KK Dhabi sales on them, right?
So what is being put up to the board was very different from what is being put up now, especially because the role of an independent director is much more defined now, and there are responsibilities which are attached which will drive the board agenda for you. For example, strategy is one place where most independent directors do need to give, because that's where it's going to, where you're looking after the stakeholders, which is your primary responsibilities.
Is that in some ways then going to blur the line between executive and non-executive? In my company, for example, I find a lot of that happening.
This is definitely aspirational and encouraging for a lot of other women.
Both the management as well as the board is responsible at the end of the day for creating the shareholders' wealth.
Now, what do you think should the government,
in terms of either driving valuation or making such a big impact?
Which in these cases it has done successfully. Now it's for the corporates to take it over.
Yeah.
Some benefit from it, some don't.
After all, you didn't have boards before, no?